avavatu sahanau bhunaktu sahaviryam karavavahai tejasvina vadhitamastu ma vidvishavahai om shanti shanti shanti. समस्त जनकल्याणी निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्म विद्वरं ओम श्री चिन्मय सद्गुरवे नमः. हरि ओम. Gurudev's grace always showering upon us. Today, it is his wish that we may ponder a little bit about Bhagavan Hanuman. Again, as we talked during Bhagavan Sri Ram's time, there won't be any Hindu who wouldn't know of Hanuman. Nobody's childhood has passed without getting the inspiration from Hanuman, the deity of strength, Hanumanta Mahabali, strength and wisdom, Vidya. A rare combination of two things we see in Hanumanta. We are all aware of Hanumanta's different stories. We are aware of Hanumanta's references in different Puranas. We also know that the earliest reference perhaps of Hanumanta as Kapi has come in Rugveda also. Although some people doubt about it, but there is definitely a reference there. And the word Marut, Maruti, has come from Marut. Marut as a word, as a devata, has been there in Vedas for a very long time. Hanumant or Hanuman is the commonest word that is known to us. And the commonest etymology of the word that we are aware of is that as Bala Hanumant, he desired to eat the sun. Of course, he went there and then Indra thought that he might really engulf the Surya. And then he threw his Vajra on his Hanu. Hanu is actually, Hanu means molar in Sanskrit. Hanu means molar. Hanu Vati. Vati is the Vati that the, that is how the word Hanuman came. This is what is generally believed. There is also a version which says that Hanuman is the word has come from Anuman. Her was not the original word. Anuman was the original word. Now the question is, the Anuman as a word has basically come from Anamandi, which is in Tamil, which means monkey. So some of the theories say that he was a Dravidian Deva who got co-opted into the Aryan culture and then got Sanskritized from Anuman to Hanuman. A becomes H. These are all just the etymological stories about Hanuman. We are not now going to discuss anything about Hanuman's stories and his Digvijaya and what all he did, because we are all aware of it. We have been hearing about it time and again. What perhaps we would like to focus on is, as a sadhaka, is to understand what is the spiritual placement of Hanuman. All are gods. Bhagavan Ram is a god. Hanuman is a god. Shiva is a god. Vishnu is a god. Then comes the question, what is so special about Hanuman, one? And what is the esoteric significance of Hanuman? at which he became small, at which he became big, all fine. What is the esoteric significance? What made Hanuman what he is? And what is his spiritual significance in our life as sadhaka? And that is when we need to understand that the gods are born to human mothers, right? It's not an immaculate conception as of Christ as called. Even Vivekananda was asked that question, that was yours an immaculate conception? But Vivekananda said, no, I was born to a mother and my mother is there, Bhuvaneshwari Devi. So in case of Hanumanta, his mother was Anjani, that everybody knows. And his father was Kesari, that also everybody knows. But the spiritual father of Hanuman was Pavana, Marut, the wind god, Vayu. So he is known as Vayu Putra or Pavana Putra. Now, Putra of two different entities, what is this scenario? He is Pavana Putra and Anjani Putra, how he can be both? And that is where the esoteric significance of Hanuman starts. By calling him Anjani Putra, of course, the Anjani Mata herself was a blessed soul. Otherwise, why would God take birth in her womb? But he being Pavana Putra, the spiritual father, every one of us has to have a spiritual father. We are born to a father and mother, that is a conception and delivery. But spiritual father means your Ishta Devata, the one who tends and cares, palyati. What is palak? Palyati. One who palayati. One who protects you. One who cares you. One who tends to you. One who wants your welfare. That is called as spiritual father. Ishta Devata or spiritual father. The spiritual father of Hanumanta was Vayu or Pavan. Now, what is the situation of Pavan or Vayu in Hindu Shastra that we need to understand? Vayu is amongst Pancha Mahabhutas, everyone is aware of it. But if we look at the way the Vayu was generated in terms of its creation, the first Pancha Tattva, Pancha Mahabhuta, to be created was Akasha, everybody is aware of it. Akasha, can you show it? You cannot. There is no characteristics whatsoever of Akasha. So that is why, except its expanse, which is called as Vibhur Vyapya or Vyoma, is also known as Vyoma. Vyomatva means expanse. Other than that, Akash has no criteria by itself. But Akashat Vayuhu, when Akash was formed, Vayu was born after that. In other words, after Vayu, Agni was there. Now, Agni was the first demonstrable, visually apprehendable entity that was born. Vayu was the first entity which was born, which was felt, not seen. So first was feeling, that was Marut or Vayu. Second was seeing, that was Agni. Third was Agni Tattva Jalam. Jalam was not only to be seen, but also to be tested. And then the Prithvi, which had all the gunas of remaining four Pancha Mahabhutas. So in this step ladder of Pancha Mahabhutas, Vayu happens to be the final frontier of created world. In other words, our Upanishads tell us that we need to transcend the creation to reach the originator of the creation. In other words, transcend the Maya to reach the Brahma Tattva. Transcending the Maya means what? Whatever is Mayopadhita, whatever has been created by Maya, we need to do Nirakarana one by one. The Panchakosha Viveka also talks about the same thing. When we do Nirakarana, we start our journey from our own place, Atma. not Atma, Atma, yourself. And then you slowly start expanding outside and thereby diminuting your ego. As you start becoming wider in approach, the ego starts becoming smaller and smaller, and then it becomes huge like an akasha. Tukaram Maharaj says, Anurenia Thokada Tuka Akasha Evada. Tuka has become, Tukaram Maharaj says, I have become like a sky. That means he went up to the tattva called Akasha. Now, after Akasha, what? After Akasha, transcendence. In other words, in the world that is created, a step before the final transcendence comes from Akasha, which is a perfectly neutral creation. But in terms of Sopadhik Vishwa, or in terms of created world, the one which dominates because of its first generation, because of its first ranking in the coming of in this world, he is given the authority to control the entire creation. And now if we look at the Vayu, is it not that the Vayu is controlling everything on this earth? We say, Wo kal chal base unhone aakhri saans le li. He breathed his last. Breathed his last means what? The Vayu is no more there. Gatavati Vayo dehe paaye. The Vayu, once it goes out, then between you and a dead log, there is no difference. So spandanam of pranavayu is what makes you alive, what makes you kicking. So also in the charachara, in the universe also, it is the Vayu who is dominating in the sense of controlling the earth itself. That means the one who has Vayu under its control, he has the control of the entire universe. And the place of Hanuman, the goddess, the god, lies in that particular place where by being Pavanaputra, by being Marut himself, and when we say Pavanaputra, there is no difference between Pavana and Hanuman. So Hanuman being the ultimate controller of the Vayu, the Charachara Vishwa is under his own control. If that is so, then if there cannot be even a normal movement that can happen without the help of Vayu, how is it possible that a man or a human being can start marching towards the self-realization without the help of the Vayu? So in other words, if you happen to be the worshipper of Vayu, then the progress of reaching the transcendental stage is bound to be narrowed down to a great level. Now, all that is said is fine. But can I have Vayu in my mind and I keep on meditating on Vayu? Can I do that? Does the Vayu, if I say today I want to sit down and meditate on Vayu? The Vayu is something which my indriyas cannot see. So I cannot concentrate on Vayu, and that is why with the grace of Lord Rama, who is nothing else but Parabrahma, he himself has given his Das, Hanuman, to us so that Vayu Sadhana could be achieved in an easier manner. Gods have always been compassionate to us. Rishis are more compassionate to us. And Lord Rama is a Rishi as well as saint, as well as Parabrahmam, as well as God. So he has rolled out for all of us an emissary of him who is a Vayu Putra, who has been given a particular shape for all of us to understand. And that is why many people who are not Hindus, who have a habit of ridiculing some of the Indian gods, it is beyond their understanding to know how can a god have an elephant head. At the same time, how can there be a god which is monkey god? Are we trying to regress backward by worshipping apes and monkeys? That is what some of the people in Western world think when they think of Hanuman. But the reason why these dull-witted people cannot understand the whole thing is they haven't understood the spiritual significance of Hanuman. In order to have, because when the gods come into the picture in the creation, they are not only interested in intelligent people and their salvation, they are interested in the salvation of all and sundry, even the pataki of the pataki, the sinner of the sinnest. All sinnest of the sinner also needs to be redeemed, because whom will he look at? And that is why Hanuman, Ram, Bhagavan Ram, Shiva, these are the gods which transcend all the different age groups as well as different ethnicities, so that everybody can identify with them. A young boy would feel like going to Hanuman Mandir because he is in the prime of youth. He wants to test the balam. Sharira Sudrudha is already Vayavashat. It is with him. Now he wants to worship the god Hanuman because that is the time when the celibacy is most important. And the god Hanuman, as he can be of reverence, as he can be of reference to the people who are at a much lower level, and when we say lower, that means we are not talking on derogatory terms, but the people who are not understanding the metaphysical purport of Hanuman can also rejoice in the name of Hanuman. How he can rejoice? They do not understand any nitty-gritties of philosophy. But the way Hanuman was doing Dasya Bhakti of Rama, if I do the same Bhakti of Hanumana, it is as good as Bhakti of Rama, that every common person knows. And that is why the relevance of Hanuman lies in the fact that at any given point of time, to anybody across the section, this deity is accessible and available as their own. And that is why the Hanuman, being an emissary of Lord Rama, whatever we tell him does reach Rama. And if that is the case, then it would be easier for us to ponder on the spiritual significance of Hanuman. Now, when we want to understand the spiritual significance of Hanuman, a thought came to the mind, where do we start? Do we start from the philosophical and esoteric explanation of Marut or Vayu Devata and give references of Upanishads and go there and then discuss it? Or should we get into the comparative philosophies and darshanas and try to see where Hanuman fits into it? Then I realize, instead of doing all that, the Kavya that is Mukhodgat to almost everyone, the Kavya that has been said by almost everybody, composed by none else than Brahma and Valmiki avatar Tulsidas Maharaj, who wrote Hanuman Chalisa, which is well known to us, if that Hanuman Chalisa itself could be deciphered the way Tulsidas Maharaj expected it to be interpreted, then the spiritual significance of Hanuman automatically opens up in front of us. Who else can speak better on Hanuman and Bhagwan Ram other than Tulsidas Maharaj, whose every breath was like Hanuman, whose every breath was dedicated to Lord Rama like Hanuman, and with the amount of bhakti that he had in his bosom, the bhav about Rama, how can he not have the similar bhava about Hanuman? And then, since he has written it, it is better to take only one text called Hanuman Chalisa and then see those pearls of wisdom lying in the Hanuman Chalisa to understand esoteric or spiritual significance of Hanuman. If we look at the beginning of Hanuman Chalisa, the first two shlokas are basically the dedication or devotion to the guru of Tulsidas. Now, here is something very important to remember. Before you talk about anybody, right now he's going to talk about Guru, Tulsidas Ji Maharaj is going to talk about Hanuman. But he has taken a pause, and first he has remembered no one else but his own guru. Why? Guru Govinda Dohu Khade Kako Lage Upai. Balihari Guru Apane Govind Diyo Dikhai. The one who showed me Ram and Hanuman is my guru. That is why I have to start with the Guru Vandana. So he says, Sri Guru Charana Saroj Raja. Sri Guru Charana. Sri means one who is Ishwara Tulya. All the Vaibhav of Ishwara is with him. Sri Guru Charana. Charana Saroj Raja. His Charana Kamal, Pada Kamal. I am a dirt of that. Raja. What is Raja? Raja means Rajoguna. there is a home called Viraja home. When you take sannyasa, you do a home called Viraja home. What is Viraja home? Vigata Rajaha. I am leaving all my Raja behind, Rajo Guna behind. But is it happening to me? No. Why? I am still struggling. I am still in Rajo Guna. My Sattva Guna Bhava is Pradipta. It is becoming Pradipta. But my Rajo Guna is still with me. That is why, I am the dirt of your feet. And I'm also Rajoguni. Sri Guru Charana Saroja Raja Nijamana Mukura Sudhar. Nijamana, my mind, Mukura, mirror. Nijamana Mukura Sudhar. My mind is nothing else but the mirror of the Lord. I am not seeing the Lord because the mirror is not clean. Chitta Shuddhata Abhava. That is why my Chitta Shuddhata Abhava needs to be cleaned. It needs to be improved, Sudhar. That is why, Sri Guru Charana, I am requesting you, please clean the slate of my mind of all the impurities. Why? Why should I clean it? Because without cleaning that, I shall not be able to describe Baranav Raghubira Vimala Yasha. Lord Rama's Yasha I want to describe. What type of Yasha Lord Rama has? Vimala. Vigata Malaha. There is purity and purity and purity alone in Lord Rama. He is the abode of purity. So in order to describe Baranav Raghubira Vimala Yasha, Jo Dayak Moola Char. Raghubira is going to give me Char Phala. Jo Dayak Phala Char. Which Char Phalas is going to give? We will find lot of different translation of Chalisa everywhere. The commonest given is Char Purushartha he gives. Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. But for a sadhaka, or a spiritual sadhaka of advanced grade, he is a giver of four types of muktis. Salokata, Sarupata, Samipata, Sarupata, and Sayujata. These are four muktis. How do we understand in simple words these four muktis? If we have to go to Ayodhya to meet Rama, first we will have to leave the place where we are staying. Metaphorically speaking, I have to leave my jiva avastha and reach to Ayodhya where Ram stays. So that is because I want to be in the loka where Ram is residing. So that if I go to Ayodhya and be with the devotees of Rama, that is my first mukti. That means I want to be out of my jiva karma that I am doing and I want to be with the people of Ayodhya. That means I want to be in the city where Rama resides. So salokata. Then I want to go to the temple where the Ram is sitting on the crown. When I go close to the temple, that means I have gone closer than reaching Ayodhya, one step further. So from Salokata, I have gone to Samipata. After Samipata, I saw Lord Ram sitting on the crown. Now I want to go and touch his feet. And to touch his feet means I have to go very close to him. Ram only allows those who are like him to come to him. He expects that we are same as him. And when it is allowed for me and I go and put my head on his feet, I have already achieved the third mukti called Sarupata. Salokata, Samipata, Sarupata. And then what happened? Then as Nanak Maharaj says, Tu karta hu bhaya mujhme rahana main. Now I touch the feet of Lord Rama and I realize that I am no more existing. Ram hamara hame japere hum payo vishram. That is called Sayujya Mukti. So these four muktis are the one who gives this mukti. Raghubir gives this mukti. Raghubir gives this mukti. Then he says, Buddhihina tanu janike sumiro pavan kumar. Buddhihina tanu janike. One translation normally done is, hey, Tulsidas Maharaj is saying that main buddhihin hu. Sawal ye uthta hai, buddhihin main jani ke nahi hai, buddhihin tanu jani ke. Tanu means what? Tanu means one that is always nourished. That means sharira. That means buddhihina sharira janike, that means the one who is embodied, who has been born as a human being, does not have a capacity because he doesn't have the kind of rutambara buddhi that is required. So I am buddhihina. Tulsidas Maharaj was a krantidarshi kavi. So he was not a buddhihina. Buddhihina to reach Hanuman. I am unable to reach to the God. That is why even though in Laukika or maybe in a Paralaukika also, I am considered to be very intelligent, I am not. Why? Because with intelligence alone, he cannot be achieved. That is why buddhihina tanu janike sumiro pavanakuma. Sumiro means smarana. What is smarana? Smaran to hum roj karte hai aur wo buddhi se hi karte hai. To ye sumiro kaun sa hai? It is memory without intellect. It's a little difficult word and it is a little difficult to understand. Memory without intellect is intuition. When buddhi is nidrista avastha, and what takes over when the mano laya happens, what takes over is intuition. If in that intuition, if I remember Pavana Kumar, then what happens? He gives me bala buddhi vidya dehu mohi balam. Hanuman is synonymous with balam. What is balam? Strong body with six pack, that is not balam. Veer, dheer. Veer means viryata purna. Sahaviryam karvavahe. Sahaviryam, a God, give us the strength and the vigor required to study the shastra so that I can approach you. That is balam. And this balam is possible when my external body is in a very safe and sound condition. My body will be sound, and that is the reason why they call it shariram adyam khalu dharma sadhanam. Sharir. Sharir means this as well as the mind. Tan, mana. Both have to be very sound, and that is why balam is meant for that. Buddhi. Now this buddhi which is required is the current buddhi that I have, the intellect. It will help me in understanding the scripture so that I can have Shastra Krupa. After the Shastra Krupa is achieved, I need to go beyond the intellect. So I want to replace my intellect with intuitive knowledge, intuition. And then what I'll be learning when my intelligence dies in terms of Vritti Jnana and arouses in terms of what is called as the Avritti Jnana or Manolaya, intuitive knowledge, that is the time I will be getting all the Vidya that I am, because that is considered to be the Vidya. Everything else is called Avidya, ignorance, ne science. So that is why Bala Buddhi Vidya Dehu Mohi Harahu Kalasha Vikar. And once if you do this, how can Kalasha and Vikara remain? What Hanuman does? He destroys the Klesha. Kalasha is Klesha. Klesh, if you see Patanjali Yoga Shastra, five Klesh are already mentioned there. Avidya, Asmita, Raga, Dvesha, Abhinivesha. These are five doshas. Now, if these five doshas are to be conquered, Hanuman has to be worshipped, because Hanuman is directly destroyer of the Kleshas as well as Shadvikara. What are the Vikaras we have? We have Moha, Mada Moha, Matsara, etc. These are also Vikara. They are called Bhava Vikara. We have Sharira Vikara also. Asti Jayate, Vardate, Viparimanate, Apakshiyate, Martyate, or Vinashyate. These are also six Vikaras. Those are also destroyed. Why? Because now Bala Buddhi Vidya has already come. Bala Buddhi Vidya of which type? Of the type which transcends the mind. And then he starts explaining this spiritually what Lord Hanuman is. Jai Hanuman Jnana Guna Sagar. Jai Hanuman Jnana Guna Sagar. Guna Jnana Sagar Nahi. Tulsidas Maharaj, when he has written this, it is not written with a conscious mind of like ours. These things are written by bhaktas only in transcendental state. That is one of the reasons they write in very simple words, and yet its influence remains there for hundreds of years. Kabir Maharaj, he speaks very simple language. Sometimes we wonder, why can't I make a poetry like that? but nobody will remember it. It is not the words, the words from where they have emanated. In the videhi avastha, in unmani avastha, in mindless or amana avastha, when the bhakta starts singing the ballads of the ishta devata, then the words have enormous amount of power. That is why entire India is glued to Hanuman Chalisa. And that is the reason why it is glued is guna, gunatita is anyway attribute of Hanumana. But jnana guna sagara, he is the one who has knowledge. And jnanagni bhasmasat kurute karma, but everything else is all delusions, mudhatva. Illusion about the world, all mudhatva is completely destroyed by jnana. And once the knowledge destroys everything and the true knowledge dawns upon you and you reach Ramapada. Now we know that Hanuman reached Ramapada. Why? He was always at his feet. Always at his feet, and this is his normal position with the folded hand. Dasya bhakti uttama is Hanuman. So when he has already done that, then when he is already in, because he is Chiranjeevi, he is in this world. So when he is in this world, he has to take help of Trigunas to work. Because anybody who comes in this world can't escape the Trigunas if he has to do some activity or some work. So Hanuman being always Chiranjeevi, being always there, all he displays is guna, but that guna is not jnana purva. It is jnanottara guna. And not only that he has one or two attributes, he is a guna sagara. That is why jai Hanuman jnana guna sagara jai kapis tihu loka ujaga. He is a kapisa. Kapisa, chanchalata of mind. Kapi or vanara, what is it known for? Known for the chanchalata, chanchalya. He is lord of the chanchalata, that means lord of the mind. He is somebody who has conquered the mind, and that is why, because of his conquering of mind, he is at a stage where all that is there in the Triloka, Tihu Loka, all that is there in the Triloka, he is the one who gives the Chetana to the world. He gives in the Buddhi that enlightenment or that kind of scintillating thing, Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi. That Deva is Hanuman. Gayatri, Surya, is Agni Tattva. Agni Tattva is subservient to the Vayu Tattva. So Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi is nothing else. The Hanuman does it with no difficulty. So he does Tihu Loka Ujagar. What Loka we have? Jagruti, Sushupti and Swapnavastha. Any other world we have? We have only three Lokas, like these three Lokas. And maybe with our karma we may have Om Bhurboha, three Lokas. In either of these three, one who is enlightening the world, the conscious principle behind everything, is Hanuman. So, jai kapisa tihu loka vijagara, that is where the placement of Hanuman is there. Ramadut atulita baladhama. He is Ramadut. Why should Ram have emissary? There were so many. Angad was also there. Then Ramadut moment we say we remember Hanuman. Why? Angad had a devotion. Vibhishan had a devotion. There were so many devotees of Lord Rama. But devotee par excellence, that is why moment you say Navavidha Bhakti, moment you say Dasya Bhakti, you don't remember anybody else except Hanuman. Why it is so? Because there was nothing in this world for Hanuman except Rama. Khana Rama, Pina Rama. Janaki Mata became angry with Hanuman when that pearl necklace that she gave as a gift to Hanuman, he broke it to do see what? Whatever you have given me, is Ram in it? Isiliye to even in India, commonly it is said, ab kisi cheez mein Ram nahi raha. What it means is, Ram nahi hai, to ramaniyata nahi. If that is the case, phir hamare karmo mein Ram hai ki nahi? और अगर हमारे कर्मों में राम नहीं है तो हाउ हनुमान कैन कम टू अस बिकॉज ही विल से दिस मैन डजंट हैव अ राम अराउंड हिम So those who say ki abhi koi Ram raha nahi, be sure Hanuman is gone. So if you want Hanuman to bestow the blessings, you have to keep Ram with you. So one way is call Hanuman, Ram will be there. Or have Ram, Hanuman will be there. They are inseparable. And that is why Ram Dut, it is the only connect of, now talking little about technical language, it is the only Sopadika Brahman which connects with the Nirupadika Brahman. So from Sopadika Brahman to Nirupadika Brahman, the bridge between the two, which is normally filled in by the Guru Tattva, is Hanuman. By that definition, every Guru is Hanuman. Or Hanuman is everybody's Guru, whichever way you look at it. Rama Dut Atulita Baladhama. Atulita. Tulyatani. There is no Tulyaman. Rama's Balam is Brahma Balam. Brahma Shakti has no parallel in this world. Anjani Putra Pavan Suta Nama. Anjani ka putra hai, lekin Pavan ka suta hai. Suta word has been used in different ways. Suta is called son. Suta is also called, Karna was known as Suta Putra of a low caste, etc. But Suta, the real meaning of Suta is one who is constantly singing the glory of God. Bhat jisko bolte the, Bhat, bard, the bard. Pavana Suta, one who constantly sings the glory of Pavana. That means one who is vibhakta of Pavana. He is never vibhakta from Pavana. He is constantly dwelling in Vayu. So he is Pavana Suta, but born to Anjani. So Anjani Putra. Anjani Putra Pavana Suta Nama. Mahabira Bikrama Bajrangi. Mahabira. Who is a Veera? Veera is Visheshena Irati Iti Veeraha. This is the definition of Veera in Sanskrit. Visheshena Irati, one who makes the enemies run away. Tramples them. He makes them run away. Which are the Shatrus? The Shatrus which are there standing between us and the Rama. So all the enemies of our mind, which are standing as the enemies between us and Rama, if we want to destroy them, our own strength may not be possible to do that job. And that is why we say, hey Hanuman, you need to do this because you are Visheshena Irati Veera Mahaveera. You are not only a normal, you are Mahaveer in that. And that is why you are already a Bajrangi. Bajranga word has come from Vraja, Vajra. Vajra Anga has become Bajranga. Vajra Anga, like thunderbolt of Indra, his body was like that. There was nothing. That is the reason no created thing could ever bother Hanuman. That is why he is Chiranjeev. No sickness can affect him. In entire Hanuman Charitra, we do not have a single incident where Hanuman was not well. Why not? Why Chiranjeevi? Because he is Vajra Angi, Bajarangi. So that is why nothing can happen to him. Kumati Nivara Sumati Kesangi. Here the spiritual significance of Hanuman comes. Kumati Nivara. What is Kumati? I need not describe because what else do we have other than Kumati? None of the times our buddhi is focused only and only on God. It is always focused on me and mine, me and mine. This is Kumati. Now we decide, maybe at the third quarter of our life, Vanaprasthashrama, that no, enough is enough. Let me now start doing something about God realization. I realize that if I have to do the God realization, I must have Sumati. I must have a good intellect, good buddhi, which is a Vivekashila buddhi. Now, if I want to have that, then how can I have that? The only way to have that is ask Hanuman. Because Hanuman Sumati ke Sangha. Moment we start having Sumati, be sure Hanuman has already started slowly, slowly moving towards us. And when Hanuman comes with our Sumati, the Kumati has no place to stay. So she is bound to go away from us. Kanchana Barana Biroj Subesha. Hanumana's Varnan has been done by Tulsidas Maharaj. Now when this Varnan was done, was he not aware that only the fair color is supposed to be the best color? Gaur Varna, nothing like that. Why Kanchana Barana? Why Kanchan, a gold, golden hue? And the reason lies in a particular thing. In the sadhana, those rishis who have reached a stage of manolaya, then God starts dwelling in them. At present, our mind is thinking as me, God is nowhere to be seen. When our ego starts slowly diminishing, the diminished space is filled by the God. And when God is more in the heart and ego is less in the heart, the God started, initially he comes, just puts his feet in the heart, then puts his another feet in the heart. That means your ego slowly starts shrinking and God slowly starts entering in our body. Now those where the ego has completely lost, they are still alive on the earth, then when the God stays in their heart, at that point of time, by vasana, by vasti of God, since God has made the abode in our body, the body physically also changes, not only mentally, physically changes. And what are the physical changes you get? I'm not talking of siddhis. I'm just talking about the changes in the body. We always say, Sadguru XYZ, he had Tejasvi Netra. Tejasvi means we also have Netra. They are not Tejasvi. What is Tejasvi? It is because the luster that comes into the eyes is nothing else but the constant humming that is happening inside of divine impulses. Same divine impulse comes on the skin and the skin tone changes to the golden color. Now one may say that, oh, this is all Kapola Kalpita. What is the proof for this? And I can give a guaranteed proof. Both Ramakrishna Paramahansa and Vivekananda have been seen and described as people with golden hue. Read the biography of any of Vivekananda's disciples, whether it is Virajananda. Virajananda Maharaj himself has very beautifully. All of them, when they came to see Vivekananda for the first time, some of them saw him in the procession when he had come to Calcutta, when he came back from the victory at Parliament of Religion. All of them have said that I saw Gurudeva with golden hue. And that is the indication of divine presence in human being, which Gurudeva himself called God-man. He is the God-man. Kanchana barana viraja subesha. Kanana kundala kunchita kesha. What is this kanana kundala kunchita kesha? Kaan mein jo kundal hai, we say that it is an earring. So what is an? To understand the beauty of God, you require God's vision. Sapashyati ya pashyati. We go to Pandharpur, we go to Tirupati and we see a murti of Balaji. Bhav is there in the mind. We say how beautiful the murti was. But when Ramanujacharya went there, for some time he could not believe because there was Sakshat Balaji standing there. Why the transformation? Why Tukaram Maharaj, moment he saw the Vithala, he started immediately saying that Makara Kundala Tirupati Shravani Kanti Kastubha Mani Virajita Tulsihara Gala Kase Pitambara Avde Nirantara Techi Rupa. He immediately started getting, he fell flat for the Rupa. And Rupa, how did they see? They saw Makara Kundala Tirupati Shravani. That is because the beauty of Lord in Saguna Swarupa is only seen by the Bhakta. Tulsidas Maharaj is seeing Hanuman in the live form. And that is why he is not interested in anybody else is going to read my Hanuman Chalisa or not. He is Utspurta. At Unmani Avastha, in Utspurta Kavya is coming. That is why he says, Kanana Kundala Kunchita Kesha Hath Vajra or Dhvaja Biraje Kande Mujanu Visaje. Ab yahan pe lot of people have interpreted that Hanuman was Brahman. We must need to understand that varnas are applicable only for common people. A sannyasi also becomes a sannyasashrami, but first thing he does it after he realizes the Brahma Tattvam, he becomes ativarnashrami. Varnashrama ullangati. They are no more into this world, so you cannot be calling it. However, if Tulsidas Maharaj has used this word, kandhe munja janeu viraj saje, that means yajna upavita. Yajna upavita means what? One who has taken vow of knowledge. Hanuman is knowledge par excellence. So that is why Tulsidas Maharaj says he has vajra on his one hand and dvaja on another. What is vajra and dvaja? Dvaja is dharma. He is a dharma saurakshanarth. He is always there for to uphold the dharma. And if somebody is doing adharma, on the left hand, then there is vajra. This is a balance with which Hanuman is in this world. For Kala Nigrahanaya, and where did he learn it? He learned it from his own Lord, Lord Rama. How was he? His face was so soft. He was so serene. However, when it came to war, when Sugriva said, Vali is too powerful a ruler, he can do this, he can do so much as archery. At that point of time, just by a smiling place, Lord Rama put an arrow which pierced through as many as 7 or 10 whatever trees, just to show. That means they have all the power in the world not to be exhibited unless required. So that is why vajra on one hand and dvaja on another. Shankara Suvana Keshari Nandana. Shankara Suvana. See, every time Anjani Putra Pavana Sutra. Shankara Suvana Keshari Nandana. Why? Keshari Nandana, because he brought Anandam to the Keshari, the father. But Shankara Suvana, he was reincarnation of Shiva. That is why Shankara Suvana. And then because he was Shankara Suvana, Teja Pratap Mahajagavandana. Teja Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi. Teja Tattva. Hanuman is Teja. Hanumana's Shishya, Hanumana's Bhakta cannot be dull-witted. It is not possible. Either if he is dull-witted, he is not doing Hanuman Sadhana. We have been chanting Hanuman Chalisa, but this hasn't gone really beyond because we are not doing the sadhana required with the same amount of intensity. So when that happens, Tej, Pratap. What is Pratap? Prakarshena Taptati. Prakarshena Taptati is Agni Tattva. That which shows its heat. Heat means spark or brilliance. Pratap, Mahajagavandana. Maha means Brahmajnani. That is why the Jagavandan is doing that. Everyone is bowing to him. Vidyavana Guni Ati Chatur. Ati Chatur. Vidyavana Guni. He is Vidyavan and Guni both at the same time. The problem is Vidya and Gunam may not go close to each other. We talk a lot about Ahankar. Invariably we see and we feel that I don't have Ahankar. I am very humble. I am very Vinamra. No. A book only if we read, a shloka only we read, which is not known to the others, immediately we feel that I am superior to him. That darpa and dambha may not be there. It may not be that bad. But abhimana, durabhimana does come by doing a little successful thing. A little success and it goes to head. That is our tendency. That is why we may become Vidyavan. In Laukik Vidya I am talking. Here it is talking about Paralaukik Vidya. But it is Alaukik Vidya. Not even Paralaukik Vidya. Our Vidya is Laukik Vidya. In Laukik Vidya also, if I become doctor, engineer, IAS, whatever, it goes to my head. Then what happens? My Durgunas come out. Hanuman is Vidyavan and Guni. Ati Chatura. This is something very important of Hanuman. Chaturyata. Chaturyata is application of wisdom at a right place. Same Hanuman who could take the giant shape of his body when he was crossing the bridge at Rameshwaram, he came across a lot of obstacles. He showed his prowess the way it was required. When he was to meet and see the entire Lanka and find out where is Sita Mata, he took Anima, Chota Roop. When it came to challenging Ravana about lifting the tail and all that, he took Garima. When it came to burning the Lanka, Mahima. So based on where to apply the wisdom, that is precisely what he knew. And that is why Yogaha Karmasu Kaushalyam. Hanuman was a yogi. He knew Karma Kaushalya, that is Chaturta. Rama Kaj Karibe Atur. He is always willing and forthcoming for what? Rama Kaj. There is no other Kaj, no Kama Kaj, only Rama Kaj. And another thing is, Kaj or Kam mein farak hai. Kam is something which we do for ourselves. Mera ek Kam hai. काज इज व्हाट यू डू फॉर अदर्स. राम काज का मतलब ये है कि मेरा काम नहीं है, बिकॉज आई डोंट वॉन्ट एनीथिंग फॉर मी, फॉर माई राम आई एम डूइंग इट. दैट इज कॉल्ड निस्वार्थी भावना. When the selfishness is not there, whatever is done is Ram Kaj. भूखा आदमी है, हमारे मुंह में रोटी जाने के पहले अगर आंख में पानी नहीं आए तो वो राम भक्त हो नहीं सकता, हनुमान भक्त हो नहीं सकता. क्यों? राम काज करीबे आतुर नहीं है, रगों में दौड़ने के हम नहीं कायल, अगर आंख से न टपका तो लहू क्या है. A Sufi says, what is the point in blood circulating in our veins if it is not becoming tears when I see pain of others? Vaishnava janato tene kahiye peer parai jane de. And this peer parai is Ram Kaj. Ram Kaj ke liye hamesha Hanuman atur hai, wahi bhakto se bhi apeksha hai. Prabhu charitra sunibe ko rasiya, Ram lakhan sitaman basiya. Now this is chopai which need to be seen little bit of attention. Prabhu charitra sunibe ko rasiya. Prabhu ka charitra, kon prabhu hai? Because Ram to dusre line mein aage, Ram lakhan sita aman basiya. Iska matlab Ram Lakshman Sita ko man mein basa ke prabhu ka charitra sunne ke liye wo ras nishpatti ke liye utsuk hai. अब ये प्रभु कौन है? Here now तुलसीदास महाराज is hinting at his own Hanumana's devotion to प्रभु. प्रभु is, who is प्रभु? ईश्वर. When in the created world, in the विश्व, when ईश्वर starts working, his working is not called कर्म. Why? Because we saw during the discussion on Rama, उत्पत्ति, स्थिति, लय, प्रवेश and अनुशासन. These are the five functions the ईश्वर does. Utpatti, sthiti, laya of the world as well as of the man or the person, jiva, as vrishti as well as samashti. At both the places, Ishwara does utpatti, sthiti, laya. Then he enters into him. That means everybody of us have Ishwara in him. Shrunanto amrutasya putraha. That is how Veda says. Amruta putra. That means the God is dwelling in us. So pravesh karta hai Bhagwan, anushasana, and then he administers whole thing. The vacho vivante nikhila yad anugrahena. Even what I am talking is because of his anugraha. If that means he does anushasana. These five functions are not called karma, they are called leela. And who does that? It is done by Prabhu. Because he does five functions, he is called Prabhu. That Ishwara charitra sunne ke liye, to listen to that, rasiya. Rasiya means sunne sunane mein bahut cheeze aati hai. Bhadram karne bhi shruniyam, that is the mantra. Bhadram means what? Bhadram means that which creates rasam. What is this rasa? Raso vai swaha, Rugved mein bola gaya hai. Rasa nishpatti. Rasa nishpatti means anandam coming out of recitation of the name of Ishwara. Raso vai swaha, rasa nishpatti. Prabhu charitra sunibe ko rasiya, Ram lakhan sitaman basiya. When is this Prabhu charitra will create rasam in our mind? Only when in our mind, who should be there? Ram, Lakhan, Lashan, Sita. These three have to be there. And not to be there for a temporary thing. Basiya, Basna, to be there for a long time. Who is Ram? Parabrahma. Who is Lakshmana? Aparabrahma. Who is Sita? Maya. If all the three are dwelling in the mind, and then if we listen to the God, then rasa nishpatti is going to be there. That is what Tulsidas Maharaj is hinting at. And this is done by Hanuman. This is the significance of Hanuman. Sukshma rupa dhari siyahi dikhava. Sukshma rupa dharan karke, he came to Sita. Vikata rupa dhari lanka jarava. With a huge and mighty rupa, he burned to ashes the lanka. Now, that means he being a Vayu putra, all the siddhis are with him. Why? The Vayu is in his hand. Vayu, charachara chalanam is because of Vayu. Now the Vayu is mastered by him. So he has all the ashtada siddhis. Ashtada siddhis is not a hypothetical thing. It exists. There are siddha purushas. That's why such people are called siddha. Siddha means with siddhi. They do not use it for personal purpose. Unless there is a divine intention, they do not use it. Anima, to become as small as possible. Mahima, as mighty as possible. Garima, as heavy as possible, robust, heavy as possible. Laghima, lighten yourself. Tukaram Maharaj even used one of the Siddhi to abdicate this world. He did not die. He just went to Vaikuntha. How did he go? In yoga, there is a prakriya whereby the existing body, like a camphor, can completely be dissolved, not destroyed, dissolved, which happens when you are into Laghima Siddhi. You become small, small, lighter, 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 and you are no more there. You become one with Parabrahman. Then there is a Prapti, one of the Siddhi. Prapti is omnipresent. You are there, you are there, you are at 10 different places. Omnipresence. Prakamya. Prakamyatai, to read others' mind. That is how Hanuman, when he was in Lanka, he knew everybody what they are doing. What is this Rakshasini doing? Will that Rakshasini harm Sita Mata? What is Janaki must be thinking? Without showing any of his siddhis, he was using them because he was Chatura. So Prakamyata is to read others' mind. He had Ishitva, lording over the Panchamahabhutas. If the brains are going to be there, ask them to wait. Even Gurudeva has done this. Then there is Vashitva, control of nature. And not only nature means only nature that we, nature means human beings also. So everybody, in other words, everything in this Chara Achara Srushti, they have the Niyantrana. So that is why Sukshma Rupadhari, Vikata Rupadhari, Lanka Jarava. Lanka kya hai? What is Lanka? Lanka is the material comfort, the golden city. Where, by having the golden city, everything in the world will be achieved. That is what the ruler thought. Dashaputra jare bisa bhuja hai. Lankapati saradara. Aise log garad mein mil gaye. He was there as a ruler. He was intelligent. He was a Brahmin of a very high order. He was a Shivopasaka. Everything was there. What it was not there was, he thought the material comforts are going to give him everything. And that is why the Asha of another lady, Sita Mata. Now what happens? The Lanka was burned. Hanuman is trying to tell us that till the time your Vaishik Vishaya Sukha, your Lanka of Vishaya Sukha is not burned. But if you want to burn it, all you need to do is call Hanuman to your place. When Hanuman ascends on our mind, material comforts or the Vishaya Sukha slowly starts dissolving. Because abhi Ravan ki abhilasha, Ram ki bhakti mein rupantarit ho jaye. Bhima Rupa Dhari Asura Savare, Ramachandra ke Kaja Savare, Bhima Rupa Dhari. Bhi means bhiti, bhi means fear. Bhima. One looking at whom people are afraid of. One who creates terror or fear in the mind because of its mightiness. Bhima Rupa Dhari Asura Savare. Who was Asura? Asashu Ramyate Iti Asuraha. Asashu means Vishaya. Those who are interested in Vishaya Sukha are called Asura. Asura Naam Te Loka Andhena Tamasavruta Ishavasya Upanishad. Asura means jo log Vishaya Me. Those who are interested only in the material subjects. Unka samvar, bhima roopa dhari. Why? Because in front of him, vishaya kaapte hai. You know, the material comforts, they do not stand for a Hanuman bhakta. They don't come. Why? Bhima roopi dhari hasura savare, Ramachandra ke kaaj savare. Agar Bhagwan Ram aane wale hai, because bhakta says, hey Rama, I want you in my abode, in my house, in my mind. If that is the case, Ram will send a dut first to clean the house. Cleaning the house is Asura Savare. That is why to Savare means, there is again, look at the word of Tulsidas Maharaj. Ramachandra ke kaj purna kije. No, Savare. Savarna kya hota hai? Savarna means already something is there which you make it better. That is called Savarna. You make it better, best, whatever. So Ramachandra ke kaj already hai. Usko savarne ka kaam ho karte. That means we are born as Rama Bhakta. In between we became Ravana Bhakta. When we again start calling for a Rama to come to the house, then Hanumana comes and does his job. Laya Sajivan Lakhana Jiyaye. श्री रघुबीर हर्षि उर लाए लाय सजीवन संजीवन क्या है संजीवन संजीवन इज लाइफ संजीवन विद्या इज लाइफ नाउ लाइफ वॉज ब्रॉट टू होम लक्ष्मण On the field, what happened? Everybody knows he was Murshita then. He bought all the Himalayan herbs and whole mountain. Forget about it. What is Lakshmana? The Mool Dhatu is Laksha. What is Laksha? The time when you have a stupor, the time when you become oblivious of your Laksha, that means you are no more a Lakshmana. Your Laksha should be on Parabrahma Prapti. If that is not happening, then for such a stuporous person, you need to give again the life so that he again comes back and starts worshipping the Parabrahman or the Rama. And that is why the one who brings Sanjeevani at such point of time is Hanuman. So the frequent drop you get in sadhana. Sadhana is not an easy thing. To reach to God is not so easy because we have come miles away from him. While walking on that path, so many adversities come, and in fact right now adversities are not to be seen by us because you are not doing the sadhana. But a real sadhaka, in spite of 10 years 20 years of meditation, it happened to everybody. That is called vishad. Rama vishad is there, Arjuna vishad is there, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa vishad is there, Vivekananda Swami went through that. Everybody goes through a point where he says that he's helpless, he did so much but God is still not seen. When that happens, then sadhana drops. At that point of time, again, the life is given to him by whom? By Hanuman through Sanjeevani. That is why laya sajeevana lakhan jiyai. Raghupati kinni bahut badhai. Tum mam priya bharat hi sam bhai. Raghupati kinni bahut badhai. Who is Raghupati? Ab Ram has become Raghupati par Tulsidas. Why Raghupati here? Why not Ram? What is used here? Raghupati, the dhatu is Ragha. There is also Rangha sometimes is used, but Ragha is the dhatu. Ragha is one who takes it to the logical end. The son of Dilip and the father of Aja is Raghu. Raghu Vamsham is, because he was so powerful, his Vamsham is known by his name, Raghu Vamsham. And Kalidas Maharaj has written a beautiful Raghu Vamsham on it. So Raghu is, Ragha is to take it to the ultimate end. Raghupati kinni bahut badhai. One who takes everything to the ultimate end means one who reaches the Brahma Pada has done the badhai of Hanuman as Tum mam priya Bharat hi sam bhai. Tum mere Bharat ke saman bhai ho. Ab sawal ye uthta hai, Lakshman ke saman kyu nahi ho? Sadhaka should not just read the things. We must get questions in the mind. Next chaupai mein Lakshman is coming. But in this it is Bharat hi sam bhai. Bharat means what? Bha plus Rat. Bha is Buddhi, Jnana Prakash. Rat, constantly dwelling in, imbued with, one who is soaked in knowledge, Bharat. That is why we belong to Bharat, place where knowledge, everybody is soaked in knowledge. They are or they are not, that's a question. But Bharat, Bharat, so Bharat hi samabhai. That means my brothers who are already soaking in knowledge, embedded in knowledge, you are like them. Or the other meaning is, you are like my Bharat, the brother who is also the one who is dwelling in knowledge. That is the reason why he created another model of himself by ruling from Nandigram, not from Ayodhya, by putting the padukas of Rama. So that is how here the Bharat word has come. Sahasa badana tumare yashagave asakahi shripati kantha lagave. Sahasa badana. It is now reference to 100 sharidas, that is Sheshanag. Sheshanaga has got 100 bodies. Now, why Sheshanaga here? Sheshanaga is because, what is Sheshanaga? Shesha word has come. In mathematics, you have this word Shesha. Kya Shesh rahe gaya? Baki kya raha? Zero raha. That means baki kuch nahi raha. When nothing else remains, who remains is Parabrahma. That is Shesha. Sheshatva means that which remains after everything is subtracted or everything is gone. So Sheshanaga is also saying to you that you are great. Tumhara yash ki gatha wo gata hai. That means Hanuman is also Brahma Tattvam. Asakahi Sripati kantha lagave. And that is the reason why Sripati, Aishwarya Yukta, or husband of all the Aishwarya, that means Bhagwan, Ishwara, Rama, aapko kantha lagate hai, they embrace you. Sanakadik, Brahmadi, Munisha, Narada, Sharada, Sahit, Ahisha. Sanaka, we know Sanaka Rushi, Brahma's four children, four sons. They were born celibate and born jnani. And they were the first with the purer mind, because they were the first born with the mind. And not only that, words of pure mind, it was the purest of the pure mind because they were not exposed to the world. Baat ye hui hai, Brahma ne jab srushti paida ki, everybody was pure. Beech mein duvidha ho gayi, everybody became impure. Nikalna kuld se sunte aaye hai, Adam ka lekin, bade beabru hoke tere kuche se hum nikli. So man has become a downtrodden. The skhalan has happened to him, but prior to that, he was a pure thing. So Sanaka Rushi, they are Chiranjeev, they are still moving everywhere in this world just to spread the knowledge. So we have Sanaka, Sanatana, Sanandana, and Sanat Kumar. These are four sun, Chatussan they call it. They, as well as Brahma, Brahma means not Brahma, Brahma, Muni, Narada Maharaj, Sharada Saraswati, and Aisha Sheshanag, Yama, कुबेर, दिक्पाल, कवि, कोविद, कहे रुके कहाँ थे? These are never tired of singing your glories because कोविद, कोविद means कोविद, one who enlightens. विद is to know. को means who enlightens. I, that is the one who enlightens, the teacher, the scholar. So कोविद, कवि. This कवि is not poet. Kavi's translation as poet is in English, not in Sanskrit. Kavi is Kranti Darshi. The one who sees what others cannot see is called Kavi. Kranti Darshi. Now, Kranti Darshi means what is that we cannot see? He sees the one who sees Brahma Tattvan is Kavi. So neither Kavi nor Kovid nor Yama nor Kuber nor Dikpal nor Sheshana nor Brahma, none of them are stopping of glorifying you. तुम उपकार सुग्रीव की किन्हा राम मिलाय राजपद दिन्ना. अभी सुग्रीव को राजपद देने में बड़ी नोज द स्टोरी. सवाल ये उठता है, सुग्रीव मीन्स हु? गुरुदेव हैज ऑलरेडी डिफाइंड इट इन रामायण. वन हु हैज ग्रीव प्रॉपर रेन्स ऑन हिज माइंड, वन हु इज वेल कंट्रोल्ड इन माइंड, संयतेन्द्रिय संयत मनः. तो वन हु इज वेल कंट्रोल्ड. But in spite of the fact that you are well controlled, it may happen that you may not reach the Atma Tattvam. Why? You require a guru for that. So in spite of Sadhana Chatushta, then after doing Chitta Shuddhi, then after removing Vikshepa from Antakarana, if you go into Dhanam, even in Dhanam, you may not be able to maintain the kind of poise that is required so that you enter into what is Gurudeva calls white heat of meditation, so that you get intuitive knowledge of Atma Tattvam. And for that you need help. And that help is done by Hanuman, and that is called Rajapata, sitting on the crown. So, Tum Upakar Sugriva Ki Kinna Rama Milaya Rajapata Dinna has this metaphysical aspect involved into it, and this is spiritual significance of Hanuman. Tumharo mantra bibhishana mana lankeshwara bhaye sab jana. What is bibhishana? B again the word B has come. A formidable person is called bibhishana. Tumharo mantra bibhishana mana. See, the bibhishan is an example of what? Righteousness versus loyalty. Being on the side of Ravana, should I help Ravana as my dharma? Or should I betray Ravana and go with Rama? Righteousness. Between righteousness and the loyalty, who guided him? Hanuman guided him. Tumharo mantra bibhishana mana. You gave the mantra. That is what Hanuman did. Lankeshwara bhaye sab janana. And then naturally he also became Lanka adhipati. He became the next king of Lanka. That everybody knows. Yuga sahastra yojana parabhano lilyotahi madhurapala jana. 16,000 miles. Yuga sahastra yojana. He went and tried to catch the sun. And because why? Because he thought that it is a madhura phala. What is the esoteric significance of that? Why would anybody write a story that a small child suddenly felt like having a fruit because it is looking red in color? What it means is abhijata jnanam that was existing in Hanuman, he being a Shiva avatar, what he was trying to do is that which sustains the earth the Mool Tattvam, the Agni Tattvam, that is what he wanted to grapple with at a time when he was not even done his Leela Karya. And that is why, even though he was a child, in our definition, he was a spiritual giant. So that is why, being Vayu Tattva, Agni Tattva has to bow in front of Vayu Tattva, because Vayu Tattva is still superior in the sense that it is the one which is closer to the Apara Brahma. It is highest, one of the highest in the Apara Brahma. It is almost the synonymous with the Hiranyagarbha. That being the stage, this is what happened. Prabhu Mudrika Meli Mukhamahi Jaladhi Langi Gaye Ajarajanahi. Prabhu Mudrika Meli. What is Prabhu Mudrika? The meaning is very simple. Prabhu Mudrika, he took his small ring into the mouth and went across the Jaladhi, the Samudra. And there is nothing surprised in. There is no surprise in this, Tulsidas Maharaj says. Sawali uthta hai, what Prabhu Mudrika is? The Prabhu Mudrika is nothing else but the Savikalpa Samadhi which he had because of Mukhamahi. Prabhu Mudrika, Mukhamahi means what? Prabhu Mudrika means the Prabhu's Murti in front of him. Where? Mukhamahi means japa. When Hanuman has reached the ajapa japa stage, every single randhra of the sharira was saying Rama, 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 Rama. Then Prabhu Chandrika rahegi ki nahi rahegi? That Prabhu Chandrika it already had. If he can see this pandanam of Rama, Rama, Rama from Bibhishan when he was in Lanka, his own body was resonating with Rama's name. Prabhu Pandrika, Prabhu Mudrika Meli Mukhamahi Jaladhi Langhi Gaye. Jaladhi. Samudra Langa Gaye ni bola hai. Sagar Langa Gaye ni bola. Jaladhi. What is Jaladhi? Jal Adhika Dhi. Dhi means Buddhi. Jala means vastness. That vastness of Buddhi, which is of no use in reaching the ultimate state, he Langhi Gaye. He went over it. And then he reached at where? He reached beyond his mind. Ab khudi ke bahar hai, hum ishq kapni pehen ke, har rang mein chola ranga didar apna ho gaya. Hanuman was in that stage. And that is how he described his visit to Lanka and meeting the Janaki Mata in this manner. Tulsidas Maharaj is now in his divine utterances further says, Durgam kaj jagat ke jete sugam anugraha tumare te. Durgam kaj jagat ke jete. People generally take this particular chaupai meaning as whatever difficulties you get in Vakratunda Mahakaya, Surya Koti Samaprama and Vigna. Vigna means they feel ki mere bachche ka admission nahi ho raha hai. These are not Durgam kaj. These are Prarabdha Vashat Karya. Prarabdha Vashat Karma is not Durgam kaj. What is Durgam? Uttishta jagruta papya varani bodhata shurasya dhara nishitaya durgam pathastam tat kavayo vadanti. That is durgam. Brahma prapti is durgam. Durgam kaj jagat ke jete. If at all in this world, if somebody is striving for atma tattvam or brahma darshanam, then for him he comes, not for getting admission to the child. And then he comes with what? Sugam anugraha. Tumare tete. Sugama anugraha means sugama. He helps you slowly glide towards the destination. Anugraha, anugrasate. Anugrasate means his constant presence is completely covering us. Sahana, sahanau avatu. Covering, protecting from all the sides. So he comes from all the sides to help us for that durgama kaj. Rama duare tumarakhware. What more Tulsidas Maharaj can say? Ram Dwaare, Ram Dwaar ka tum rakhwala ho. Is it possible that unless you speak to the security guard, you can meet the master? So Ram Dwaare, tum rakhwaare. In other words, there is no way one can approach and reproach Rama unless Hanuman is in our favor. So it goes without saying that the link between Jiva and Brahma, Brahma is Rama, Jiva is ourselves, the link between the two is Hanuman. That is the spiritual significance. So, hotan agya bina paisare. Potan Agya Bina Paisari. Without your permission, Hanumana, there is nothing possible, Tulsidas Maharaj says. But with you are with me, then Ram has to come. Why? Because Ram and Hanuman are inextricably interwoven. So, ek ko pakdo, dusra ahi jata. And that is why pakadna asan Hanuman ko hai. Aprapya ghost hai Ram. Aprapya kyo? Prapya karne ke liye madadgar is Hanuman. Sab sukh lahe tumhari sarana, tum rakshak kahu ko darna. A true Hanuman bhakt cannot be afraid of anything. Why? Sab sukh lahe tumhari sarana, tumhare sharan mein sab sukh hai. If I surrender to you, prapatti, if I surrender to you, I cannot have any problem. But what is the surrender? Hum roj bolte to hai Bhagwan ko, Bhagwan tum hi ho, main tumko sharan aa gaya hu, but hota kuch bhi nahi hai. Kyun nahi hota hai? Kyunki sharan ki vyakhya jo Ramanujachari ne di hui hai, that we don't follow. What is that vyakhya? Anukulasya sankalpaha. Pahli baat. Shadvidha sharanagati bolte. Chhe cheeze honi chahiye sharanagati mein. Anukulasya sankalpaha. That means talk only what is favorable to your God. Pratikulasya varjanat. Do not say, do or think anything against your Ishta Devata. Rakshasyati iti vishwaso. You must have faith and confidence that I shall be saved by Hanuman. Rakshasyati iti vishwaso. Goptrutve varanam tatha. Goptrutve means mera khana pina ye wo sab kaj wo dekh lega. Ab mujhe koi chinta nahi hai. Only sustainer is Hanuman. Atmanikshepa. Atmanikshepa means meri kya haisiyat hai. Main to jo Bhagwan ka maine rakha hua aadmi hu. Hanuman ka main sevak hu. That is atmanikshepa. Karpanya bhava. Karpanya bhava means negligible entity. I am nobody. Hanuman was time and again asked, who are you? He said, I don't know. I know nothing. I cannot answer anything except one word, Lord Rama. My existence is nowhere. That is called Karpanya Bhava. Anukulasya Sankalpaha Pratikulasya Varjanam Rakshasyati Iti Vishwaso Goptrutve Varanam Tatha Atmanikshepa Karpanya Shad Vidha Sharanagati. If this is there, then Tum Rakshaka Kahu Kodarana. Not before that. Apan Tej Samaro Ape Tinhi Loka Hakataka. Who can describe, who can control, who can subdue Hanuman? No one. Why? Only he knows how he does everything. Being omnipotent and omniscient, he is aware of what is happening, what is bound to happen, what is likely to happen. Kartum, akartum, anyatha kartum. All the shakti is with him. And that is why the hakatakape is the occult intent in hakatakape. When does he does that bhubutkar so that everybody is afraid? If he decides to make everybody afraid, he is already doing it now. It is all at God's hand. If Hanuman wants every one of us to mind our business, he can make it happen anyway. We know what is happening now. So in any case, it is up to him. Then comes Bhut Pishacha Nikatanahi Ave Mahabira Javan Nama Sunave. Ab sare scientific log, scientific mind, highly educated, they start objecting. How can you have Bhut and Pishach? It is not established at all. That means Hanuman Chalisa is not scientific. Unfortunately, with whatever little knowledge we have, there are many people who have a habit of making wild allegations. If it is asked to us that whom would you believe more? Would you believe Ramakrishna Paramahamsa? Would you believe Vivekananda? Would you believe Gurudev? Or would you believe anybody else? Our answer should be Sraddhavan Labhate Jnanam. Our answer is whatever Swami Vivekananda, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Gurudeva says, I will believe in it. Not only I believe, I have faith in it. If that is the case, then let us understand if Ramakrishna Paramahamsa himself described to Brahmananda Maharaj that whole night we both are sitting here, but there are two ghosts sitting there. They are constantly looking at me because in front of pious person, the ghosts feel very uneasy. And for that one night, they were staying together. And that's why he said that I saw them there. And then Brahmananda Maharaj asked, Maharaj, what were they doing? He said they were eating the bones thrown by the British soldiers in the dump yard and they can eat through their eyes. In short, what I'm trying to say is Ramakrishna Paramahamsa did mention about ghosts. Vivekananda not only mentioned about it, one of his relatives became a ghost and was trying to always talk to him. Ultimately, he was taken out of the Pishachi Yoni by Swami Vivekananda himself. If this is, these two concrete evidences are there, let us not believe in anybody else. Bhuta Pishacha Naketanahi Ave Mahabira Jav Nam Sunave. Ghosts and evils cannot come. Why? Because purest soul, which is nothing else but Hanuman, when he is there, where is the question? Nasho Roga Hare Sabapira Japat Nirantara Hanumanta Bira. Nashe Roga Hare Sabapira. Rog kaun se hote? Rog sharir ko hota hai, sharir bhogta hai, rog man ko hota hai. Mind has the disease, body suffers. And sabse jyada mind ke rog kaun se hai? Bhava rog. The rog that this world happens to be true to us and we become extremely selfish in it, that is the rog. And sab pida, what pida we have? Pida, we have our own pida created by our prarabdha. Adi daivik, adi bhautik, adhyatmik taap is pida. Now, if all these are to be removed, and not only removed, they are to be removed forever, then japati nirantar hanumanta bira. Nirantar, this is a very important word. Nirantar, there should not be a gap in devoting, in doing bhajan of Hanuman. Constantly, every breath. Sasa sasa par namale vrutha sasa na khoy. Na jane is sasa ka avan hove na hoy. So japati nirantar hanumanta bira. So Hanumanta, if it's remembered constantly in a japa form, then where is the rogue? When balahari, balashali is in my shariram, roga pida cannot be of any. In fact, pidas will be there as per the prarabdha, but they will not attach or affect me. So many sad incidences have happened in Ramakrishna Paramahansa's life, in Vivekananda's life, where they disturbed. That means pidas were there, but as good as they were not there. Why? Because Hanumanta was already existing. Neem Karoli Baba, one of the enlightened sadhu of North India, he was reincarnation of Hanumanta. He had absolutely no issues with whatever was happening. So that is why Sankat se Hanuman chudave manakrama bachana dhyana jolave. He will remove you from Sankat, provided manakrama bachana dhyana melave. Manakrama bachana, mind, deeds and words. Manakrama bachana. Tan man dhan, man krama bachan. If that is in dhana, meditation, then he will definitely chuda away from sankat. Which sankat? Janma marana sankat. People take this as material kind of Hanuman Chalisa. It is not material kind of Hanuman Chalisa. Maine shares mein invest kiya hai, sankat ke Hanuman chuda away, paise ki zarurat hai. That is not Hanuman Chalisa. Sankat is only one. Only one sankat we have, that we are born. And the only solution is, I need not be born again. And if I don't have to born again, martyo amruto bhavanti, Kathopanishad. If that is what is to be happened, then manakrama bachana dhyana lagave. Sabapar rama tapasvi raja tinike kaj sakal tumasaja. This is a specific chopai where a lot of elaboration is required. Since we have almost taken a good amount of time, if again, time permits, maybe remaining part of Hanuman Chalisa, and in that reference, the significance of Hanuman as a spiritual giant can be studied, very well studied. It all depends on how and when we put the next lecture. But whatever we have discussed so far, one thing is there, that Hanuman, in terms of a god, the way it appeals to us, has much more deeper significance for a sadhaka than what we see normally. All the bahya upchar we have to do on a Saturday, go to Hanuman temple, do Hanuman Jayanti, use that sindoor from Hanuman is full of sindoor because he is Navanidhi, that is going to come later on, Saptasiddhi, Navanidhi. There are a lot of discussions on that. They have a lot of philosophical significance. We must do that. But what is more important is, bahya upchar is 10%. More important is to understand Hanuman in the relative reference of a sadhaka journey, so that we can ask for the blessings of Hanuman to come to us based on whatever time we again decide. Maybe remaining part of Hanuman Chalisa we can discuss and perhaps enlighten all of us. That all depends on Gurudeva's order and Ajna whenever it comes. At this moment, I think we will give Vishram to the Vani. Hari Om. Purnamidam Purnat Purnam Udachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om. Each Mahabhuta has one quality, two quality, three quality, four quality or five qualities. That is called Panchikaran Vidya. So Panchikaran is another subject. But when Vayu comes, Vayu has only Sparsha and Spandana. Akasha has no Sparsha. So as we move from Akash to Vayu, Vayu to Agni, Agni to Jala and Jala to Prithvi, we find that in this first tattva is Akasha. Then when we come to Vayu, Vayu has its own guna and also takes guna of Akash. If we come to Agni, Agni has its own guna and takes guna of Akash and Vayu. When we come to Jala, Jala has its own thing and takes previous three gunas also. So Prithvi being the Panchama Tattva, it has its own guna plus the gunas, four gunas of the previous Panchamahabhutas. So that is how Prithvi is described. Now it is because it is in the form of earth, but the earth is too small a thing to call as a Panchama Tattva, Prithvi, when we say. In cruder language, Prithvi is earth, fine. What about Jupiter? It has got Panchamahabhutas there also. The whole universe is made up of Panchamahabhutas. Any Panchamahabhuta who exhibits all five is called Prithvi. Now, whether it is here, there, or your geographical locations are not the limitations in our science, in the spiritual science. That is one part. Second part is, if you are able to reach Rama directly, then there is no need of going to Hanuman. The reason is very simple. If supposing that you need a horse to reach a destination, you can fly to that destination also, provided you have an ability to fly. Now, the question of ability to fly means, if you are a Nirguna Nirakar Upasak, there are few. There are very, very few. In fact, Bhagavan himself in Bhagavad Gita says, I am just mentioning it, not many are there possibilities. So that's why I am coming to Saguna Sadhana, when he is talking about this Nirguna Nirakar. Rama Niranjana Nyarare. Rama is Nirguna Nirakar Brahman. Shuddham Nityam. That Brahman is not easy to be attained so easily, even if I try my level best. Why? Imagine the person who is in first standard, he says that, what if I directly go and write a dissertation for PhD? Idea-wise, it's not a bad thing, but it will not happen. The reason is, you require a teacher to take you up to that point, and then we'll say, yes, I need a teacher. Hanuman, under the created world, in the Sopadhika Brahman, where you have a deity in front of you, whose dhyana you do, so that through that dhyanam you reach forward. That is where that deity itself takes control of you. In other words, in ahangraha sadhana. Ahangraha sadhana means what? Ek graha man mein karna hai, ki main hi Bhagwan hu. It's not out of arrogance or ego. You say that Vishnu Pada is me, I am Vishnu. And then start doing this sadhana. So in the beginning you say, I am worshipping Vishnu. That is, you are doing murti, and that murti you are talking as Vishnu. Slowly, slowly, as you move forward, ahangraha upasana comes. Tapovan Maharaj did ahangraha upasana. But while doing all this, you realize that all the deities which are there, because at the same time, when you move in spiritual progress, you also move towards the same loka where the devas are existing. So you reach devaloka. That is what in Kathopanishad we saw as Brahma loka. Loka world is there, Brahma, not Brahman, Brahma Loka. So you go to Brahma Loka and Krama Mukti, and later on at the time of world dissolution, then you go to Parama Brahma. So going to Rama directly or reaching Rama directly is Nirguna Nirakara Upasana. Abu aisa hai na ki some people can digest the wheat. They can eat the wheat and they be healthy. But others require chapati to be made for the digestion. Moment you say chapati to be made, there has to be somebody who makes the chapati. Similarly, Hanuman is the person. Hanuman is the deity for us who guides us. So that is why as a Ishta Devata, Hanuman Stuti we are doing. So naturally Hanuman as an esoteric significance we try to see. But suppose somebody says that, no, I am not interested in Hanuman. I want to just go for Shankar. There is no absolutely objection on that. But later on, ek chaupai ka aane wali hai, jisme Tulsidas Maharaj khud bolte hai, ki agar aapne Hanuman ki puja ki, to kisi aur dev ki taraf dekhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Very bold statement he has made. What he is trying to say is, ek ko pakdo. That's called Ishta Devata. Ek ko pakdo. Isilie ek mantra, ek dev. The reason is very simple. Don't fetter your energies on too many things. So that is where the significance of Hanuman lies and the difficulty of reaching Rama directly lies. Hariyam.
Hariyam.
Hariyam, Sanjay ji, I have a question here. I'm not sure. There are not a lot of other versions available, like Bajrang Band is also there, and also, are these also equally old, or they have been created recently? I'm not sure on this. I just wanted to whether if you, in case you are aware.
Yeah, Hariyam. On Hanuman, since Hanuman has been into the scene, so a lot has been written. Different people as well as rishis on down the line. It is only that part of divine plan, some of the devotees of Hanuman, are real devotees of Hanuman, given a specific way, perhaps Tulsidas. So Tulsidas's Hanuman Chalisa became a standard, almost a standard 15th century for as well as both. Now, similar kind of people came to Valmiki when he wrote. So there are people who have written different things. Only thing is, when somebody who is writing or saying is a person, the Hanuman Tattu, then whatever he has written, he must become important, become gaya, become good to listen to, people get into it, even though they are simple words. Frankly speaking, Avadhi language, a language not known to many people these days, because that time it was, but it is not known yet. By heart it and say, for a very simple reason, there must be some force that is directing him to do that. That means Hanuman is prevalent in heart. And that is why, in order to satiate that particular appetite of people who want to, because of their poor uttam karma, they want to take the name of Lord Ram or Hanuman, they go back to such kind of things. But yes, like Hanuman Ban and other things, I have not read them at all. But there are many, many versions also, like the way Ramayana has many versions. They are Kamban Ramayana, etc. They are also of standard authority also. But overall, in the whole picture, the most authoritative text, and one is enough for us. Aap Ganeshwari padho, Bhagavad Gita padho, do book dikhti hai ek. Lekin Ganeshwari bhi padhunga, Bhagavad Gita bhi padhunga, Yoga Vashishth bhi padhunga. Then the question is that how many days we have? So that is why from that angle, one version of Hanuman Chalisa, as Hanuman Stuti, as well as to understand Hanuman esoterically, it is enough for us.
I can only say thank you being a postman, because ye money order meri nahi thi.
Thank you, Sanjay ji. Hari Om. Manish ji will be in touch with you for scheduling the next one. Hari Om.
Hari Om.